Here's what to do when your iPad won't turn off. First of all, if your iPad doesn't have a home button, this top button, pressing and holding that, activates Siri. It doesn't bring you to that slide to power off screen that you want to get to.
It's not like the good old days.
Not like the
they
good
don't
old
make them like they used to.
Yeah, so if you want to get to that screen, it's just the top button, press and hold that simultaneously with either volume button. We're not doing that right now because we have a screen recording, but you can also turn off your iPad in settings.
Let's open settings. Little gear icon down here in the dock. We're in general already, shut down.
Tap shut down.
Boom.
That'll bring you to the slide to power off screen there. Swipe it.
Yep.
Easy.
Still going.
It's possible that your iPad won't turn off because it's frozen and it's just stuck on. In that case, do a hard reset. That'll force your iPad to turn off and then back on.
Right. To do a hard reset on an iPad without a home button, quickly press the volume up button, then the volume down button, and then press and hold the power button, the top button. I guess it's not the power button.
Called top button.
The top button.
Technically.
The top button. So volume up, volume down, top button until the screen goes black and then the Apple logo appears on the screen. And then let go.
Mm-hmm. If your iPad does have a home button, power button, press and hold. Maybe it's the top button now and the old iPads too, but it used to be the power button.
Yeah,
whatever.
It used to be a sleep wake button. Power button was never, yeah.
For a lot of people, the problem is probably fixed by now. Mm-hmm. Give this video a thumbs up on your way out the door. Subscribe for more great iPad videos.
Well, that
now,
was a compelling reason to subscribe there.
Well, we fixed the problem.
We fixed your problem. Yeah. You owe us.
You owe us.
There you go. Reciprocity. We did something for you. There you go. Marketing.
You still owe me.
Yes. So a lot of the time when you can't turn off your iPad, it's because one of the buttons is broken,
mm-hmm.
and that's kind of a pain, and you could go get it fixed, or you could turn on Assistive Touch for a quick workaround. And
Assistive Touch saved a lot of people a lot of money at the Apple Store back in the day, and it is still a feature. Let's go to Accessibility, and then we're going to go to Touch. Then we're going to tap on Assistive Touch at the top, and then tap the switch on the right side to turn it on. That gives you this little virtual home button that you can then drag around anywhere you want to onto the screen, sort of, and then you let go and it snaps to wherever it wants to go because it's just more of an illusion of control. So then you can tap on that, tap device, and then tap more, and then tap
restart.
Restart. But that's not really shutting it down, is it? But it will turn off and then turn back on.
Yeah.
Right, indeed. Excellent.
So if your iPad froze and the hard reset fixed the problem, back up your iPad because there's a software issue that we haven't actually resolved yet.
Yep, only if it's frozen. Listen, let's be honest here. It might not be that serious of a problem, but it is always a good idea to have an iCloud backup or an iTunes backup or a Finder backup on a newer Mac, just in case.
Mm-hmm.
You never know when you're going to drop it down a flight of stairs or, you know, leave it on top of your car, use it as a cutting board.
Mm.
Plenty of ways that iPads can get broken. Have a backup.
Yep.
Always a good idea. I'm just going to turn off Assistive Touch right here.
Oh, go for it. And if the problem does persist, try a DFU restore. It can really just eliminate those pesky software problems.
Right. It's interesting because you'd have to get it to turn off to do the DFU restore, but it might work because David's right. It could be a pesky software problem. That is the reason it won't. Anyway, DFU restore, deepest type of software restore you could do on an iPad. Takes everything off, puts it back on again. Make sure you know your home Wi-Fi password before you do it so that you can log back in and then restore from your iCloud backup. So it's a little bit of a time drain. Could take 10 minutes to DFU restore and another 20 to restore. It's a half hour of your life you're losing here, but it could fix an iPad.
Yeah, if there's a display or a button issue and you want to get that fixed, Apple.
Apple. And if you go to the Apple Store, they will do the DFU restore for you.
Mm-hmm.
So make sure you have a backup before you go in because then that can become a long appointment. Nobody wants that. Also, make sure you make an appointment before you go in because they might just say you have to go home.
Yeah, well, while you're waiting in the Apple Store, you could join this channel.
Right. And you wouldn't be the only one, would you, David?
You'd join Heather.
Yep.
K.E. Wolf.
Heather, yeah, we appreciate every person who joins, so much so that we're giving them shout-outs. So.
And they also got early access to the iOS 15 battery tips video.
Yeah, and they could show with us in our Discord. Amazing.
Giveaways.
Giveaways. Somebody, yep. Somebody won a 4-pack of AirTags so far. Somebody else won a pair of headphones.
Yep.
Anyway, we have
K.E. Wolf.
Yeah.
We got Roderick B., Rebecca W., C.A.C., and Julie A.G.
Right. So apparently we are being anonymous with the last names, even though it's on the page.
Well, they can't read that. Maybe they can.
If they can. This is a 4K video. Our cameras are excellent now. Thank you to Sony. Yeah, I like the dog here, Julie's. CAC looks like a happy person.
Yeah, right? For sure.
Yeah, Rebecca?
Join these great folks, get a bunch of perks, get your name shouted out.
Thank you to all these great folks.
Video.
Yep.
Give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. And once again, thanks for watching.